Good morning, welcome to our Living Water Lake Church. This morning we are celebrating the second Sunday of Easter, also known as Divine Mercy Sunday.
As we begin our celebration, we pause for a few moments in silence, asking the Lord's mercy and forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, your mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your Son of God and Son of Mary, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Praise you.
Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal Feast kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand, and how font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was one of heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed to each according to need. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let's have this right now say, His mercy endures.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God, and everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way, we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome, for whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world, but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ, not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you. On the evening of the first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now, a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side. And do not be unbelieving, but believe. Thomas answered and said to him, My Lord and my God. Jesus said to him, Have you come to believe because you've seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed. Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book. But these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief, you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus said to his disciples, Peace be with you, 3 times. Jesus is telling you and me today, he wants us to have peace in our life. I think many of us see today, we live in a chaotic, sinful world. Truthfully, I am worried. However, I must trust in God. When Jesus died, the disciples thought, we need to hide. We are defeated. We lost. I can't believe Jesus is dead. What happened? In 3 days, he rose from the dead and appeared to the disciples to give them hope, telling them, they did not lose. Weren't you listening, I told you? I told you I must die so that I can live. When the disciples realized that it was Jesus, they were amazed with joy, and they came to believe. Nothing would stop them from spreading the word of Jesus. So much that they were willing to give their life before shutting up. And many of them did lose their life. But they knew that there was life after death, and that Jesus promised them that they would be in paradise in heaven. Scripture tells us, who is this Jesus? He is the Son of God. He is the beginning, the end. He's King of Kings, Lord of Lords. He made everything on earth. The mighty sea, the sun, the moon, the sky. All the animals, the birds, and the fishes of the sea. He made us in the image of God. He has freely given us the Holy Spirit and the free gift of faith to all those who believe in him. We are not to keep that gift locked up in our hearts. Share that gift with our children, with our families and our neighbors. We, the believers in this world, must bring light to those in darkness. Easter Sunday, and also today, it is nice to see the Mass filled to its capacity. Jesus said, anything is possible for those who believe in him. Believe that we can live in a world that is not sinful, a world that there is no hatred, no violence,
no respect for others. Full of sin, a world that appears to be ran by Satan. A world that people think there is no reason to give forgiveness to others. A world that thinks there is nothing wrong with killing another human being. Jesus died for our sins. And he loves us so much that he gave his own life. Jesus wants us to live a godly life. He wants us to live at peace. This Sunday is Divine Mercy Sunday. Jesus pours out his mercy to the soul that goes to confession and receives communion. Through the mercy of God, we can be the spiritual beings that God created us to be. We shouldn't think we're not good enough. God made us that makes us good enough. Jesus has shown us the way. It is up to us to trust in him. My brothers and sisters, if we want peace in our lives, it is essential to stay close to God in prayer, to trust in his ways, and to sin no more. This week, we should take some time, go outside, take a look around at all the blessings that God has created in this world. Take a deep breath. As you breathe in, receive the Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit, rekindle in me the fire of your love. And let us all say amen.
Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so, now that our Lenten observance has concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and his works, and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan and all his works? All his empty show. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? And may Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life.
Amen.
And now we be sprinkled with the Easter water.
Thank you.
trust in God's infinite mercy, let us bring our petitions before Him.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For Pope Francis and all pastoral leaders, may Christ draw them ever closer to Himself and intercede in their every need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For civic leaders, may the Lord bless them with the skills and talents they need for the communities they serve. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who face addictions, may God's grace give them courage in their struggles. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those gathered here and all whom we love, through the grace of the Holy Spirit, may we grow ever closer to the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are ill, especially Elaine Krissek, Jack Minton, Zach Biedermeisdorf, Philip Sherman, Kevin Matos, John Cosdrone, Frank Torrey, and Sandra Robert. May they receive the gift of good health. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Thomas Pops Adams and George E. Nieder and Faye Scalera, may they soon rest with the angels and saints forever. Let us pray to the Lord. In silence, we include our personal needs and petitions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Merciful Father, we who believe in you without seeing you give you thanks for your gracious mercy. Hear our prayers we offer today through Christ our Lord. Sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people and of those who have been brought to new life in baptism, that, renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord. Lord, be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is God.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, Lord. But in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb, who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created right to give you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and of all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Kevin, our Bishop, and Arthur, our retired Bishop, and all other people, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you this morning. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Sisters in Christ, let us pray the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of
Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the risen Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of our Lord's peace.
And of the Lord.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Eucharistic ministers, please come forward to help with communion. May the body of the Lord Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for this song.
This Sunday is Divine Mercy Sunday. We will have a holy hour beginning at 2 o'clock. There will be Eucharistic adoration, and we will pray the Chaplet of Divine Mercy in song, the Holy Rosary, and some other prayers. It will end with benediction. Jesus attached a great promise with this feast. Please come join us.
Lord be with you,
and with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.